September 11th, Friday. We are at Cadia Fields. Our first real day of rain. It's a Neolithic, huge Neolithic site. And these are the cliffs into the Atlantic. From here, we're heading towards Carrowmore. And then to Sligo. First discovered in the 1930s as a local man cut his way through peat for fuel, it took another 40 years before further excavations. Then investigations uncovered the complex of fields, houses, and megalithic tombs concealed beneath the centuries-old bog. Okay, we're at Carrowmore, largest megalithic burial site in Europe, I believe. Just following around, it's about 1 kilometer by 600 meters. Large cairn in the middle, possible passage tomb, though they've never excavated it. Visitor center, and then across the street. Will be some more. So we're still having to deal with the rain today. We're almost in Sligo. Just a brief stop here at Carrowmore. And it's been a quiet day of driving. Enjoying the scenery. The rain, the gray, the green. Now we'll just keep going around looking at the tombs.
Carrowmore is one of the largest complexes of megalithic tombs in Ireland and is also among the oldest used passage tombs, with the earliest burials dating to about 3700 BC. 30 monuments survive while others fell victim to quarrying.
All right, looking at these, it's kind of hard to imagine that they would even be Neolithic sites. That's why we have archaeology. So they would put human remains in here.
Most of the sites are satellite tombs surrounding Tomb 51, named Listigil, the cairn on the high point of the site. Like Newgrange, Carrowmore is classified as being part of the Irish Passage tomb tradition. Listigill is the focal point around which the other tombs were built, and it's the only tomb that contains inhumations rather than cremations.
Alright, for them to say it's never been excavated. Go on. Crow. That's beautiful. So a good look inside the dolmen. So then we had to cross the street. Alan decided to stay in the car. It's just wet and cold. He told me to take my time. So I will have to go over to that one. Ground is covered with mummified cow pies, so I have to be careful. Goodness gracious, that's my foot, that's the cow pie. Sligo and the Glasshouse Hotel, room 407. Start with the bathroom. Alan runs out the door so he doesn't get in the video. Guess what? He's in the video. Bathroom. A very nice little assortment of goodies. A toilet. A high tub that I must be careful not to kill myself as I get in and out. And this is the one place where they apparently had no option and had to give us a double bed. I guess, okay. Coffee service, tea service, desk, and our view of Sligo with the waterfront down that way and city center up that way.
Cannonball is the largest organized road trip in Europe. It features 170 high-end cars that blaze a trail through towns and counties, stopping along the way for onlookers to enjoy.
Oh, too bad it's inside. Can't get a good shot of this one.
And that is the Glasshouse Hotel.
Sligo Abbey was originally built in 1253 by the order of Maurice Fitzgerald, Baron of Offaly. It was destroyed in 1414 by a fire, ravaged during the 9 Years' War in 1595, and once more in 1641 during the Ulster Uprising. The friars moved out in the 18th century, but Lord Palmerston restored the abbey in the 1850s. This site contains a great wealth of carvings, including Gothic and Renaissance tomb sculpture, well-preserved cloister, and the only sculptured 15th century high altar to survive in any Irish monastic church.
Yeah. I'm